So I think he was an absolute love. I just great love the guy.
All right. Now, I'm a massive fan of the Haunted Mansion, your work, and with the Museum of the Weird, I'm curious to know, like, what is your favorite piece of the Haunted Mansion today? Your favorite scene, favorite character, anything?
Well, my favorite piece is all the illusions. Yale Gracie came up with illusions that were absolutely incredible. And if you took the illusions out of the mansion, it wouldn't be the mansion. So I think the illusions are what the secret was, and I felt very fortunate to work with Yale and help design some of those illusions. It was just great.
Now, I know that you worked on the Tower of the Four Winds for the World's Fair and for Small World.
Yes.
Yes, all right. And so, you explained your inspiration kind of in that documentary with the pencil clip. What else inspired you while building the Tower of the Four Winds?
Well, the little propellers that I had in my office really inspired me. I know there was a fellow in animation that I worked with, and I'd go into his office, and he always had this little stupid propeller going around. And I kept saying to him, how do you do that? And he says, well, it's a secret. And so I knew that it was a clip out of the pencil. So I probably broke up, I don't know how many pencils and clips trying to get the damn thing to work, and I couldn't get it to work. And I kept going back into his office, and I said, how'd you do that? How'd you do that? And he said, it's a secret. And this went on for, I guess, about 6 weeks. And so finally one day he says, I'll tell you what, Roy. He says, I'll tell you how I did it, but first I'll sell one to you. I said, good, I'll buy it. I said, how much? He says, a penny. So I said, I gave him a penny. And he gave me the little propeller, and then he explained to me about how to do it, because I had ruined more little clips trying to make them work. And what it was a ballpoint pen that he would make the dent in. And so therefore the pen would write up the little thing that was kind of half round. I had been using, nails. And the problem was the propeller would get caught, pen would get caught in that, in the hard part that you dug out. So anyway, I was thrilled. So I built one, and I was so proud of it. It was a little helicopter, and I had it in my office up on the wall, and it was going like crazy. This young kid came in from the art price department, and he said, how'd you do that, Billy? I said, I'll tell you. I'm not going to charge you a penny, I'll tell you. So I told him how to do it. So he went back to his office, and he built one. And so he called me and says, I built one of your propellers, really. I said, fine. Well, when I went in there and saw it, he'd taken cardboard discs, little soft discs, and glued them to his little propeller. Well, his propeller was bigger than mine. And actually, so I went back, and if you remember some of the films there, I filled my whole room with propellers, and it was really great. We had a lot of fun.
Very nice. Thank you.